So the last class to be discussing how the glucose molecule which are completely oxidized. One glucose molecule which are completely oxidized means a glucose molecule which are entered to four pathway, namely glycolysis, oxidative decarboxylation of pyruvic acid, Krebs cycle and electron transport. Last class discussing regarding what the first three chapter. Last one is called electron transport chain. Electron transport chain is nothing but a chain of electron carriers. Which includes NAD plus, FAD plus, coenzyme A, then flavo protein. Then cytochromes. Among the cytochromes, what are types of cytochrome to be involved is commonly called as cytochrome A, cytochrome B, cytochrome C, cytochrome A. The glucose molecule, it is completely oxidized at end of regarding what the citric acid cycle. You know that citric acid is also called regarding what the Krebs cycle. So at the end of citric acid cycle, glucose molecule which are generated to produce NADH2 and FADH2. These NADH2 and FADH2, it is completely oxidized, but not energies are produced. But when it can be producing energy, the productions of NADH2 and FADH2 enter into regarding what electron transport chain. There, NADH2 molecule and FADH2 which are broken down, which is releasing energy. So what are the definitions of electron transport chain is commonly called as transfer of electron and proton from NADH2 and FADH2 through the electron carriers such as flavo protein, cytochrome C, cytochrome B, cytochrome A and cytochrome A3. So the transfer of electron and proton from NADH2 and FADH2 through the electron carriers. For carriers of electron are to finally, which one is to be utilized is commonly called as half molecules of oxygen. There are half molecules of oxygen utilizing all kinds of electron. At the end of the nature, they can be formed regarding what water molecule. There is a common electron transport chain. Okay. Glycolysis occurs in cytoplasm. Oxidative decarboxylation pyruvic acids occur in mitochondrial matrix. Krebs cycle occurs in a mitochondrial matrix. Electron transport chain is also occur in mitochondria. Where is occur in the mitochondria? Inner membrane of mitochondria. Did you learn that mitochondria structure? This structure, this is a matrix. This is an outer membrane. This is inner membrane. This is a crystal. So the kinds of rectangular is very situated commonly called as inner membrane or mitochondria. So according to the modern concept of regarding electron transport chain, the electron carriers are arranging in four complex. Complex 1, complex 2, complex 3, then complex 4. For modern concept of view, electron carriers are arranged in four complex, namely complex 1, complex 2, complex 3, complex 4.
Okay.
For here, if NAD plus is first acceptor of electrons, that NAD is reduced into NADH2. When NAD is a first acceptor electrons from the electron carriers, mean the NAD is present regarding but a complex 1. So that NAD carry electrons from complex 1 to complex 2, complex 2 to complex 3, complex 3 to regarding but a complex 4. So if NAD is the first acceptor of electrons from NADH2 and FADH2, means the carry of electrons from complex 1 to complex 2, complex 2 to complex 3, complex 3 to regarding water complex 4. Each complex, they can produce regarding water ATP formation. Adenosine diphosphate along with the phosphate is commonly called as ATP. Each complex. Here, adenosine diphosphate along with the phosphate, ATP. Then adenosine diphosphate plus phosphate decrease produce regarding what is ATP. So if that's regarding the need point of view, if NAD is the first acceptor electrons, the electrons carry from the electron transport chain, the electron move from complex 1 to complex 2, complex 2 to complex 3, complex 3 to complex 4. So that I am indicating you. One molecule of NADH2 grays produce 3 ATP. Do you know? That denoted like this. If NAD is the first acceptor electron, mean that are generated to produce regarding all the 3 ATP. 1, 2, and 3. Instead of NADH2, FAD is a regarding what acceptor of electrons. So FAD plus B should be FADH2. So FAD, even it can present regarding what a complex 1, but it is not associated. So instead of NAD, FAD is the first acceptor electrons, mean FAD is moved from complex 2 to complex 3, complex 3 to regarding what a complex 4. So that can be generated produce 2 ATP. That's why I am already telling you. One molecule of NADH2 that can be generated to produce 3 ATP. One molecule of FADH2 produces 2 ATP. That is the base on like this. So instead of NADH2 or NAD, the electrons are carried regarding what FADH2 means. The FADH2 can move from complex 2 to complex 3, complex 3 to complex 4. That's why the FADH that can be generated to produce 2 ATP molecules. Okay, yeah. For the structural view, for the electron transport chain, which is the terminal component is commonly called as half molecules of oxygen. That half molecules of oxygen pick up some kinds of port on the electron transport chain. What do you mean like this? For the electron transport chain, the terminal component is commonly called as half molecules of oxygen molecule. That half molecules of oxygen molecule, what is the play vital role is commonly called as, carries some kinds of port on the electron transport chain, which are pick up
electrons, the half molecules of oxygen which Guris produced regarding water, water molecule. That is the neat point of view, these two is the important component. For electron transport chain, terminal component is commonly called as water, oxygen. What is the vital role of oxygen? Pick up some kinds of electron and proton from electron transport chain, which form regarding part of water molecule. Okay, anyway. In electron transport chain, phosphorylation takes place. Simple to say, phosphorylations occur during electron transport chain, such a phosphorylation is commonly called as oxidative phosphorylation. So at the end of regarding what electron transport chain, all NADH2 molecule, all FADH2 molecule, which are completely broken down, which are releasing energy. How much amount of ATP molecule which are generated is commonly called as the chemical Guris produce 38 ATP molecule produced. That is 38 ATP molecule, how it is obtained? That's a commonly called as is going to discuss it. Energy yield. So how it can be obtained regarding water 38 ATP molecule for the stages of regarding water respiration? Yes. Stages of respiration. Number of molecules of ATP, NADH2 and FADH2. Then total number of ATP molecule. Yes. What are the first stage? Glycolysis. For glycolysis, how much ATP and how much NADH2 and how much FADH are obtained? So 2 ATP and 2 NADH2, no FADH2. You know already in the video. These two is commonly called as substrate level phosphorylation. What is substrate level phosphorylation? Phosphorylation which are takes place during substrate reduction regarding component. Substrate level phosphorylations occur in glycolysis as well as regarding water Krebs cycle. So these two is called what? The substrate phosphorylation. Then 2 NADH2. I am already indicating to you 1 NADH2 equal to 3 ATP. So how much NADH is there? 2 NADH2. So totally 6 ATP from NADH2. 2 ATP is already there. So total regarding what? 8 ATP. Then second stages. Oxidative decarboxylations of pyruvic acid. Here there is no substrate or phosphorylation. The chemical Guris produce 2 NADH2. There is no FADH2. So 1 NADH2 equal to regarding what? 3 ATP. So totally 6 ATP. The third one stage is Krebs cycle. For Krebs cycle, the chemical Guris produce 2 substrate level phosphorylation, 6 NADH2 and 2 FADH2. So two substrate or phosphorylation their component. Six molecules of NADH to mean one NADH equal to regarding but three ATP. So six NADH is purely produced regarding about 18 ATP. So 18 ATP from NADH to four ATP from FADH2, because one FADH is equal to regarding about 2 ATP. So here for Krebs cycle which can be produced 24 ATP molecules totally supplied. That's why huge amount of ATP molecule which are responsible producing mitochondria. Mitochondria they can be considered regarding but the power house of the cell. For the total amount of ATP molecule, so consists regarding what the 38 ATP molecule. Here is a 4, here is a 30, here is a 4. So out of regarding what 38 ATP molecule, 30 ATP molecule from NADH2. That's the point of view. 4 ATP molecule is derived from FADH2. 4 ATP molecule from substrate level phosphorylation. This is a chromatic called as energy yield. Yes. The next topic we're going to discuss about triple P. That's a call pentose phosphate pathway. How to be commonly called as triple P. Some another names also they can be presented. That's a car. Hexose monophosphate pathway. Or also known as direct oxidation pathway. These are another names of regarding water triple P. Okay. What are the specifications of regarding water pentose phosphate pathway mean? In all living organism, glucose molecule which are completely oxidized, they happen regarding water four stages, namely glycolysis, oxidative decarboxylation of pyruvic acid, Krebs cycle, and electron transport chain. In anaerobic condition, molecule is not completely oxidized, which is partially degraded. Why it will be going to regarding what the positive means? Because of the absence of oxygen. So here is not involving glycolysis, oxidative decarboxylation, pyruvic acid, Krebs cycle, and electron transport chain. In anaerobic condition, the glucose molecule which are partially degraded by the means of only one regarding bar, glycolysis alone involved. There is no one involvement of other stages of oxidative decarboxylation, pyruvic acid, Krebs cycle, and electron transport chain. So, pentose phosphate pathway, where is occurring commonly called as? It is our occurring cytoplasm. F-
For the partial degrade of recording glycolysis, when the year of 1938, scientist Dickens discovered alternative pathway of glucose molecule in living cell. That the alternative pathway is commonly called as pentose phosphate pathway. So in majority of organism, the glucose molecule which are completely oxidized, there are four stages. But some organism is not in utilized such a stages. It can be alternate pathway to utilized to break down of glucose. That alternate method of glycolysis method is commonly called as pentose phosphate pathway. The pentose phosphate pathway, they exist in two stages, namely oxidative phase and second one non-oxidative phase. Before emptying schematic representation, what are the special features of regarding what oxidative phase? The oxidative phase is what is special features commonly called as formations of RU5B. What is called RU5B? Ribulose 5 phosphate. One more information from regarding oxidative phase mean productions of NADPH2. These two, it is the essential features of regarding what oxidative phase. What are the end product of oxidative phase? Formations of or productions of RU5B, that's a called ribulose 5 phosphate. Or one more features of oxidative phase is called what? The productions of NADPH2 by the oxidation of NADP+. What is the features of regarding non-oxidative phase is commonly called as formations of glucose 6 phosphate. These are two important species occur in pentose phosphate pathway, namely oxidative phase and a non-oxidative phase. Oxidative phase is what are the special features called? What the formations of RU5B and as well as regarding what productions of regarding what NADPH2. Non-oxidative phase, what is the special features commonly called as productions of formations of glucose 6 phosphate molecule. How it can be produced such a regarding pathway? So going to record schematic representation. For schematic representations of regarding what to do be, the first product is called but glucose. So glucose is phosphorylated in the presence of ATP molecule. What are the phosphates pick up regarding what glucose to form glucose 6 phosphate? With the help of enzyme hexokinase, the reduction is commonly called as what? ADP. Then glucose 6 phosphate is oxidized in the presence of NADP+, reduced into NADPH2. So glucose 6 phosphate is oxidized in the presence of NADP+ to form 6 phosphoglucose
lacto 6 phospho glucose lactone is derived from glucose 6 phosphate by means of regarding oxidations of NADP plus, which enzyme to be help is commonly called as glucose 6 phosphate dehydrogenase. The next step is 6 phospho glucose is hydrated. That means additions of water molecule to form 6 phospho glucuronic acid. With the help of enzyme glucuronolactonase, then 6-phosphoglucuronic acid is further oxidatively decarboxylated. To form ribulose 5-phosphate, that is oxidative phase. So what is the end product of regarding what oxidative phase called? What is it? Ribulose 5-phosphate. That ribulose 5-phosphate is going to be entered to regarding what the non-oxidative phase. When enter of regarding what ribulose 5-phosphate in non-oxidative phase, there can be increased produce so many number of regarding what phosphorylated sugars are formed. What are the phosphorylated sugars commonly called as? 3-carbon compound, 4-carbon compound, 5-carbon compound, and 7-carbon compound. These are commonly called as phosphorylated sugars. What are the 3-carbon compound? Glycerol derived phosphate. What is 4-carbon? Erythrose phosphate. What is 5-carbon? Xylulose phosphate. What is 7-carbon compound? Pseudoheptulose 7-phosphate. These are the commonly called as non-oxidative phase. During non-oxidative phase, out of 6 glucose molecules enter into the pathway. After oxidation of 6 molecules of glucose or 6 molecules of glucose 6 phosphate, how much NADPH2 and how much carbon dioxide produce commonly called as? These are called 1 molecules of schematic way. 1 molecules mean 2 NADPH2 and 1 carbon dioxide. How much molecule actually enter into regarding what triple P in commonly called as 6 molecules of glucose or 6 molecules of glucose 6 phosphate center. So that can be easily produce 12 NADPH2 and 6 carbon dioxide. This is a neat point of view. 1 molecule of glucose for oxidation it can be easily produce 2 NADH2 and 1 carbon dioxide. But actually in this pathway, how much number of molecules which can be entered in, it's mean like this. 6 molecules of glucose or 6 molecules of glucose 6 phosphate enter. 1 molecule means 2 NADH2 and 1 ADP. If 6 means 12 NADPH2 and 6 molecules of regarding but carbon dioxide released.
Okay.
Why? Pentose phosphate is also commonly called as hexose monophosphate pathway. Hexose means 6, you know? Yes. Out of 6 glucose molecule, only one glucose molecule only is a completely oxidized.
Out of 6,
only one glucose molecule only it is a completely oxidized.
Remaining 5 all are transformed into intermediate phosphorylated sugars that can be formed. That's why hexose monophosphate pathway. From that 5 molecules of glucose, from the 5 molecules of intermediate phosphorylated sugars, 5 molecules of glucose 6 phosphate is regenerated. So these are commonly called as schematic representations of regarding about triple P. In 8 point of view, how much amount of molecule it can be regenerated from regarding about non-oxidized phase? Because out of 6 glucose molecule, only 1 glucose molecule which are completely oxidized, remaining 5 molecules of component, it start forming so many kinds of intermediate phosphorylated sugar. From that intermediate phosphorylated sugar, that 5 molecules became produced into 5 molecules of glucose 6 phosphates regarding what regenerated. It's a pentose phosphate pathway.